to the heart of Texas and the very wonderful AT&T Stadium in Arlington. Charles and I have been looking forward to this one all week, and we are underway from AT&T Stadium. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. Dak going to start out going to the air. Escaping the pressure right. Pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Got to hope that's not a sign of things to come as they face an early second and long. Here's Prescott. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. He finds his man, complete. It's Ferguson.
From just across the midfield stripe, here's second and 3.
They run it for the first time with Tony Pollard, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
First down, Prescott. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
And partner, to me, that one was all about timing. If he's there too early, it's going to be a pass interference call. If he's too late, it's a completed pass. He was Johnny on the spot on that one.
On second down, it's Pollard. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are against traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On 3rd down, it's Prescott. Goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be spotted just shy of midfield, a 59-yard attempt, and this is good. He got just
down at the 11.
Looks to throw on first down, and that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
I may be an analyst, but I'm also a fan. But he was under a lot of duress, and I think that forced the incompletion downfield. Didn't have a real good chance.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. The tank, DeMarcus Lawrence with a sack.
All right, partner, I'm going to be Captain Obvious right here. Not the start you're looking for offensively, right? Incomplete pass, followed by a sack.
And when he went down, it looked like that right ankle got turned, but thankfully he popped up okay, and they breathed a sigh of relief on that sideline. Miles Sanders, first carry of the game. And he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job. Got it, now it's their turn to take it downfield.
And from their own end zone, it's a fake. And this is caught. Shoves him aside. And the gamble pays off. They get the first. So not only do they convert on 4th, but they pick up 22 yards in the process. And I don't know what the method is to know when to dial up a fake punt, when not to, whatever the method there, it worked for them.
I think you actually did explain it. There is no method. It's just a feel, a sense, and a healthy dose of guts in order to call that play in that situation.
Element of surprise, I guess, right?
Yeah, element of surprise and just a strong belief that, hey, we're going to get it done.
Now a first down throw for Young. There's another one complete to Shenault. And he'll have a gain of 3 to the 33. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Panther football to start quarter number 2 as they've got it 2nd and 7.
Ready, break.
They run with Sanders off the option. And he's got this pretty close to a first down at the Cowboys 26. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
It's not a huge breakaway run, but if your starting running back finishes the game with averages of 5 or 6 yards per touch, you'll take that every single time.
On 3rd down, they'll run it with Sanders. And he's going to get the first down here as he's taken down at the 22. Throw offside on target to Thielen. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of 2. They go play action. Young. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. Young on 3rd down. And that will be incomplete. This is up and good from Pinion
down to it. I thought that was pretty good stuff.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them 3. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it. And he goes out and gets the job done for them, but I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10. To throw is Prescott. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So from Panther territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 37-yard line. Out of the gun to give to Pollard. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. From the shotgun, it's Prescott, flush to his right. He wisely will throw that one away.
And that's the knowledge you gain from being in this league for a long time. He's learned the hard way when to give up and fight another down. And that's a smart move to throw it away.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. On play action, Prescott. This one swung out to Vaughn. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. He'll be marked down at the 1. Prescott urging his guys to go quickly. They need to get up and set. Pollard one more time. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down. Prescott. That's dumped off to Pollard. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
It's all about teamwork.
And no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this. Fourth and goal from the 3. Now Prescott. And it's intercepted at the goal line. And Xavier Woods with a pick. And the Panthers are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Well, Charles, certainly circled that play. We might have to revisit it later. They had 3 in their back pocket. They go for it on 4th and goal and throw the pick.
Well, you know, we're still in the first half. A bold call nonetheless. And I guess the book might have said, take the 3. But it looks like they burned the book and just said, give me the analytics. And the analytics said, go for it. Didn't work out.
It's Young off play action. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number 1. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. To throw, Young. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
In motion is Chenault. A second down throw for Young. And that's caught inside the 35. Now the Panthers going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Could we get a touchdown in this first half after all? It's 1st and 10. On play action, Young. It'll buy some time right. Now throw on the run, but that's going to be incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple of more times and get off the field before giving up any more yardage.
Looking to throw, Young. Flushed out right. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
As we both know, there's a lot that went into why they made him their first round pick this year. Part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
1st and 10, Young. He's got Sanders on the out route. It's caught. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. So the completion results there in 9 yards. Young. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up 1st and goal. Now Young. Touchdown, Panthers. Chuba Hubbard probably should have opted for the touchback. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And with 10 seconds left, not really enough time to put something together. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Got an open man, it's Michael Gallup. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. He's going to take a shot at the end zone. Why not? It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. Good coverage there by the kick team. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Now this game has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Young off the play fake. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. DJ Chark, 48 yards. And the Panthers come right out of the locker room and score to the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
On first and 10, Prescott. A short one there taken in by Ferguson. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down.
Now Dak, he's going to mix it up.
Prescott off play action. Going right back to Ferguson. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 22-yard line. Gun. Here's Prescott. Touchdown! Brandon Cooks! A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Cowboys have got it back to a little score. To begin their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And he's just going to run right into that big old defensive end, and that play going nowhere. So still 14 yards to go, second down. Throwing, Young. And once again, this is Sanders. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. 14 yards, good for a Panther first down.
And when you have success throwing the football, the old cliche becomes true. The playbook opens up wide, and these screen passes, they become even more difficult to stop.
On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
The chart goes in motion left.
Second down, back to Sanders.
And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and seven. Is that one officially a loss of one?
I know the speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
On third down, they turn to Sanders. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 61 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. 2 first downs have him up near midfield now on first and 10.
Man in motion left, Mingo.
Another run with Sanders. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. So both teams trade touchdowns, and the third as we're through 3 quarters of play. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
From the 44-yard line, here's second and 2.
They'll try to throw now. Young. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Just because you've got the lead in the fourth, it doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
And this offense on third down today, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll try and run for it with Sanders. And this is not going to be enough. He was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there. This, they'll change it at the line. And it is caught. And he's taken down inside the 30. Fourth down, no problem. Just a ho-hum pickup of 14 to keep the offense on the field.
Boy, that was a big gamble for them right there. They went for it on fourth down, showed a little chutzpah because they did it with the lead here in the fourth quarter. And this defense is once again unable to stop them.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. So after a rare misstep on this drive, they'll try to make amends on 2nd and 15. Young now. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. Now Young going to move him around. Running right. Here's Sanders. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. Set to throw. Sharks got it left side, and now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. And the Panthers turned away on 4th down, and the Cowboys defense is going to get them the football back. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Now 2nd down and a few inches. To throw is Prescott. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there.
Well, he certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball. up another.
And the 2-minute warning. Here's first and 10. Prescott. That one too wide and incomplete.
No receivers open downfield, so instead of forcing the ball to the sideline, he's going to throw this one down to Fort Worth. He'd rather have the incompletion than the turnover.
Second down, Prescott. This is caught, it's close. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 44-yard line. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Prescott. That throw right side here going to be incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Here's Prescott. Eluding the pressure right. And they'll find the open man. That's complete. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Plenty of time and two timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here. To throw, Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
Ooh, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its bounds.
From the 17, they work on second and 10. Here's Dak. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. From 17 yards, 25-yard line. This is first and 10. They start on the ground here at Sanders. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game.
Here's second down.
Here's Young. He'll dump this one off to Hubbard. What do you think? Play this safe, just running back in, no team?
Yeah, don't make any risky throws. It's going to change the outcome. But if anyone slips, take the big shot.
Open man right side is short. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter.
Well, this offense still has the one timeout here, remember. First and 10.
A give running left. It's Sanders. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. He's going to want to run up and tackle him.
Young. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And this is taken in at the five. And he will reach the five-yard line before going out of bounds.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
Here we go, first and goal. Young to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. There have been quite a few plays they might look back on and say, we really have hurt ourselves, and that was another example.
And this is late game execution. Everything on the line, so it all has to come together properly. The throw is made. Where's the catch? Got to catch in that spot.
They go back to the ground with Sanders. And he's in for the touchdown. And in the final seconds, just take a knee, and they'll put it out to the 25. They'll come up first and 10 here.
Right set, boys. Let's get a few yards in this play. Keep the chains moving. Oh!
Time to shine, offense.
What do you think? What
is he saying? Come on, come on. Now Dak. Into the hands of Cooks. And a timeout is called. So now you're looking at probably just one final play from back in their own territory. And they're going to need a miracle. Here's first down. Now Prescott. This to possibly force OT. And that is going to be incomplete. Boy, they got the tip they were looking for, but couldn't secure it. And this one's over. And a fun, close ball game comes to an end. On that last play, Charles, they were on the wrong side of midfield. They needed something near a miracle, and they couldn't get it done.
Yeah, the effort, that was good. Very good, in fact. They were just a little too far out to get a decent look at the end zone for that last opportunity. Couldn't get it done.
プレイステーション